Battleship Missouri takes her place in Tokyo Bay for the official surrender of Japan, the end of the greatest war. Aboard comes Admiral Nimitz, welcomed by Admiral Halsey, battle commander of daring tactics. The Missouri scene of Jap surrender is Halsey's flagship. General MacArthur, to whom Japan must make submission. MacArthur commanded on Bataan when American forces were overwhelmed in the Philippines. He pledged, "I shall return." He did return to the Philippines and now has come to Tokyo Bay to preside over the triumph, the end of a long, hard road to victory. The Japanese emissaries arrive. The surrender delegation coming aboard the Missouri is headed by Foreign Minister Shigemitsu. He has a wooden leg after an assassination attempt in Manchuria. In top hats and frock coats of diplomacy, they are like undertakers at their country's funeral. For the Japs, it's the end of a road of bandit conquest, invading China, forming alliance with Nazi Germany, taking advantage of the European war to strike in the Pacific, the Pearl Harbor sneak attack, and inhuman atrocities in war. The end of their road is utter defeat. With a dramatic sense of the historic meaning of the event, MacArthur opens the ceremony of surrender.
We are gathered here, representatives of the major warring powers, to conclude a solemn agreement whereby peace may be restored. The issues involving divergent ideals and ideologies have been determined on the battlefields of the world, and hence are not for our discussion or debate. It is my earnest hope, and indeed the hope of all mankind, that from this solemn occasion, a better world shall emerge out of the blood and carnage of the past. A world dedicated to the dignity of man and the fulfillment of his most cherished wish for freedom, tolerance, and justice. As Supreme Commander for the Allied Powers, I announce it my firm purpose, in the tradition of the countries I represent, to proceed in the discharge of my responsibilities with justice and tolerance while taking all necessary dispositions to ensure that the terms of surrender are fully, promptly, and faithfully complied with. I now invite the representatives of the Emperor of Japan and the Japanese government and the Japanese Imperial General Headquarters to sign the instrument of surrender at the places indicated.
Shigemitsu comes forward to sign. The terms provide for Japan to be stripped of stolen empire, Japan to be occupied by Allied troops, the Japanese Emperor to be under the orders of MacArthur, a democratic Japanese government to be installed. The Japanese Armed Forces, General Yumitsu signs the terms providing that the Japs everywhere in the lands they seize shall lay down their arms and yield.
The Supreme Commander for the Allied Powers will now sign on behalf of all the nations at war with Japan. Will General Wainwright and General Percival step forward and accompany me while I sign?
Honor paid to Wainwright of Bataan and Corregidor. As for the victors in World War No. 2, General Douglas MacArthur signs. One of the pens he presents to General Wainwright, who commanded during the last bitter days of Bataan and Corregidor, who was a prisoner of the Japs and who is a guest of honor now. To British General Percival, who commanded at Singapore, he presents another pen in the signing. Admiral Nimitz, American Pacific Fleet Commander, signs for the United States and President Truman. These motion pictures made by Army, Navy, and newsreel cameramen were flown to the United States in a record-breaking trans-Pacific flight. History told in film. China signs. General Su representing the nation longest in the war against Japan. For Great Britain, Admiral Sir Bruce Fraser. Other allies participate, the Netherlands, France, and the British Dominions. Canada, represented by Colonel Cosgrave, signs the pact. For Soviet Russia, General Derevyanko. And so ends the greatest of wars.
Let us pray that peace be now restored to the world, and that God will preserve it always. These proceedings are closed.